my YouTube workout buddies, and welcome to this week's workout. Today we are doing a strength focused kettlebell workout, and this workout is really going to help you tone up and build up that muscle mass. So for this workout, you will need a couple different kettlebells. Mine are 20 pounds and 35 pounds, but obviously, you know, use what you have available. And you'll also need, this isn't essential, but if you have one of these bands, go ahead and grab that. It's just gonna be used for a couple of exercises, but I'm gonna give you alternatives if you don't have the band, so don't worry if you don't have the band, it's all good. It's just for the warm up anyways, so yeah. Okay, so we're doing a strength circuit, and there's 10 exercises, a variety of different rep ranges, different weights. It's gonna be full body, top to bottom, and yeah, it should be good. So if you're a beginner, you know, aim to do one or two rounds. I'm gonna be doing three sets, or I'm gonna do the whole circuit three times in this video. But if you're a beginner, go for once or twice. If you're more advanced, go for two to three circuits. You know, if you wanna go full out, gung-ho, do the whole video with me. I think it should probably take around an hour. Around there, we'll see how fast I can get it done. Yeah, so we're gonna do a rep-based warm-up. So go get your equipment, go get some water, and let's do this. Alrighty guys, let's get started with the warm-up. So the first thing we're gonna do is just do 20 body weight squats. So let's get ready, and here we go. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, 9, 10. So when you're doing the squats, keep your chest up, your core braced, send your hips back, and then squat down, keeping your spine neutral. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. All right, come down into tabletop. We're gonna do bird dog. 10 reps total, so that's 5 per side. We're gonna alternate sides. Come in, like I said, tabletop position, brace the core. Now you're gonna extend one arm, one leg, keeping everything else still. Now switch sides. 2, really squeeze that glute. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. Good job. Okay, now we're going to warm up the legs a little bit more with some three-way lunges, 5 per side. So lunge to the front, lunge to the side, feel that stretch in here. Now one reverse lunge. So that's one, we're gonna do that, excuse me, 4 more times. Front, side, back. 2, front, side, back. 3, front, side, back. 3, front, side, back. 4, front, side, back, and 5, switch legs, front, side, back, front, side, back. Keep your chest up and your back flat. Side, back. Was that 2 or 3? I don't know. 1, 2, So let's just call that three. Front, woo. Brace the core to maintain balance. One more, front, side, and back. Great. Okay. Now, put on your bands if you have the bands. Now I'm just gonna show you, oh sorry, no, not quite yet. First we're going to wake up the core, sorry, the spine a little bit more. So come into a squat, a deep squat, push your elbows against your knees, kind of just like rotate around, feel your hips moving in their sockets. Now we're gonna do five twists per side. So I'm gonna twist and look up towards your arm. One, switch sides. Two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, and 10. Good job. Okay. So now you're gonna put your bands on if you have the bands. And in a moment, we're gonna do glute bridges first, but in a moment we're gonna do lateral walks. And if you don't have the band, you're going to do fire hydrants. So when I say lateral walks, you don't have the band, you do this, okay? So you're getting on to all fours and you're gonna squeeze your glutes and you're gonna just lift your knee up to the side. So you're kind of like squeezing the side of your butt, if that makes sense. All right, and you're gonna go for, let's say 15 to 20 reps per side. Okay, so that's your option. So, but if you do have the bands, let's go ahead and put the bands on. I really love these things. They're so versatile. So I highly recommend ordering some of these if you don't have any, because they're really cheap and they really just add little dimensions to your workout that I'm really enjoying. Okay, so we're gonna do 20 glute bridges. So brace the core, push through the heels, squeeze the booty up and lower down. Now again, if you don't have the bands, you're just doing the same thing. Going for 20 reps, four. Doing the same thing, but just without the band. The band just helps activate the glutes even more. Seven, eight, nine, 10, one, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10. All right, so now we're doing those band walks, and if you don't have the bands, you're gonna be doing the fire hydrants. All right, let's go. Actually, I'm just gonna move the bands down a little bit to make it slightly more challenging. And I'm just gonna keep going until I just can't anymore. It's just burning like heck, which it's already burning. So keep your core braced and your chest up. Whew. I'm gonna give it a little rest, retie my shoelace, and we'll go for one more round. All right. Let's do it. Oh, it's burning already. It doesn't take much with this, those small muscles on the side of your butt, right? Okay, I think that's enough. So now we're gonna do 20 more glute bridges. And
I try keeping the band down there because I usually have it above the knees, but I've never actually tried having the band below the knees. Let's just see what that feels like. Okay, here we go. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 10 more. You'll feel that your butt is just like already burning after having done those side steps, right? 1, 2, 3, push through the heels, brace your core. 4, 5, 6, 7, oh my gosh. Oh, putting it below the knees, I feel like it's harder. 8, 9, 10. Hold it up, squeeze, contract your glutes, hold. And lower down. Whew. Alrighty. That was good. Let's remove the bands. Now you're gonna wanna get your kettlebells ready. Oh, and one thing I forgot to mention in the intro is if you have a stability ball, grab it because we're gonna need it. If not, you can just use a chair. And you'll also be needing a chair, so yeah. Okay, let's start circuit number one. Okay, here we go. Grab your heavier kettlebell. We're gonna do some kettlebell swings to begin the workout. So 20 reps, here we go. Brace the core and hinge at your hips. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, squeeze your glutes. 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Good. All right, you can put the weight down. I'm gonna grab my, let's try it with the heavy weight. So now we're doing a squat with an overhead press, 12 reps. Squat, press. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. Nice. Okay. You're gonna grab your ball or get on your chair. We're gonna be doing a single arm chest press. I'm using my lighter weight for that. So support your upper back and your neck and lift your hips, squeeze your glutes and press down and up, 12 reps per arm. Or, you know, depending on what kind of weight you're using, if it's heavier, basically do as many reps as you can. Okay, here we go. 1, 2, 3, 4, don't forget about your squeezing your glutes. 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, and 12. All right, going to switch arms now. I think I might try the heavier weight for the next round and just do less reps because I actually need like a 30 pound weight for this exercise, but my choices are 20 or 35. So I'm gonna try 35 next round, but I'll probably only be able to do like 8 of them or something. 3, 4, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10, 11, 12. Good. All right, lunge pass-throughs. Yeah, so something I want to mention in this workout is like, yeah, you're going to have different weights than me, so tailor the amount of reps to the type of weight that you have. You want to make it challenging, but yeah. Okay, so for lunge pass-throughs, what you're going to do is you're going to step back. So hold the weight in your right hand. Now step back with your right leg. Pass it through. Okay, now you're going to step back. Weight should be in the left hand. Step back with your left hand. Pass the weight through. So each one of those is one rep. We're doing 20 reps. Okay, let's go. One, two, three, brace the core, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Great. Okay, incline plank row. I'm going to be using a chair for this. So you're going to get into a plank. Pick up your kettlebell, squeeze your core, squeeze your glutes. Now the arm with the kettlebell is going to come straight back up towards the ceiling. So you're going to feel like you have something, like a string pulling your elbow straight up. Not out to the side, what have you. Keep your hips facing the ground. So when you're doing this exercise, do not rotate your core towards the arm. What a lot of people do is they rotate their core towards the side that they're working. So don't do that. Just keep everything stable, braced, pointing towards the ground, okay? So we're gonna go for 10 reps per arm. So here we go. I'm bracing my core and my glutes, and here we go. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10. Other side. Reset, brace the core, the glutes, go. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10. Nice job. All right, bicep curls. So this exercise, I'm probably gonna only be able to do like 8 reps because I'm using the 35 pounds and I'm super weak at bicep curls. But if I did use the 20 pound kettlebell, I could do like 30 reps. That's too many. So I'm gonna go for the heavier weight. So just do as many reps as you can here, okay? All right. One. Two. Three. Four, five, six, seven, eight, 9, 10. All right, I did 10. Good job. Okay, single leg deadlift. So let me just demo this movement. You're going to brace your right leg, lift your left leg. You're going to hold the weight in the left arm, and you're going to bend over as though you're picking something up off the floor, and you're just going to keep your back and your hips stable. And I like to stay in the range of motion that my back stays, my spine stays neutral, so I'm not going to put the weight down all the way to the ground, because if I did that, my spine starts to move. So I'm not doing that. So I'm just going to about there. Okay, so you should really feel this in your hamstrings and your glutes. This is a challenging exercise, so you know, don't worry if you're wobbling around and stuff. That's normal. Okay, 10 reps per leg. Let's go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Seven, eight, gosh, I hate this one. 9, because it's challenging, and 10. All right. I could go for the 20 pound, but I just feel like that would be too easy. So I'm just gonna challenge myself a little bit today. All right, other side. One. Two. Three. Keep your back flat. 4. Five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten. All right, now we're gonna go for a goblet squat, holding the heaviest weight, 15 reps. Okay, here we go. 1, 2, 3, 4. 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Good job. Okay, next exercise, sumo deadlifts. So you're gonna have your feet wide apart, toes pointed out. Okay, that's the front. I'm gonna show you what you're gonna do from the side. Okay, so pick up the weight. So now, brace the core, send the hips back. Now bend, keeping your back flat. Put the kettlebell down. Now straighten your knees and return to normal. So hips back, bend the knees, straighten the knees, hips forward, okay? So it's kind of like four movements. It's one, two, three, four, okay? So we're gonna go for 15 reps of those. You really wanna focus on squeezing your glutes, feeling it in your hamstrings and your inner thighs for this exercise. All right, here we go. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. All right, last exercise in the circuit, Russian twist. So, you can come down onto the ground, going for 20 reps. Here we go. You can leave your feet in the air or on the ground, it's up to you. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10. Make sure your back isn't rounding. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10. All right, good job. So we completed one round. We've got two more just like that. All right, here we go. Grab your weight. We're doing squat and press. Work those shoulders. 12, kettlebell swings first, 20 reps. Here we go. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, 9, 10. All right, put the weight down for a moment. Moving on to the squat with overhead press. Let's go. One, 12 reps, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10, 11, 12. Nice. Okay. Grab your ball or your chair. Let's see how many chest presses I can do with a 35-pound kettlebell. I have a feeling it's not gonna be too many. All right, here we go. One. Push the hips up, brace the core, squeeze the glutes. Two. Three. Four. Five. Six, seven, eight. I got eight. Okay, other side. Remember, keep the hips up, squeeze the glutes. One, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. I don't know why it's so much harder on the other side. All right. Get rid of the ball. Lunge with a pass through is next. I wonder if I can do it with the heavy one. No. Way too unstable. Okay. So again, hold the kettlebell in your right arm. Step back with your right leg. Pass it underneath and step forward. Okay? Let's go. One. We're going for 20 reps. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Great. All right. Incline plank row. So get into your plank, brace the core, squeeze the glutes, pick up the kettlebell. 1, 2, 3, 4. Don't rotate. 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Put the weight down, shake it out for a moment. Moving on to the other side. Again, come into a plank. Now remember that elbow is coming straight up to the sky. No rotation. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Great job. All right, bicep curl. Wipe the sweat off my face. Here we go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Good job. Drop it. Okay, for a single leg deadlift this time, I'm actually gonna go for the lighter weight because my form wasn't really that great with the heavier weight, so I'm just going to do that. So right leg first. So stand on your right leg, hold the kettlebell in your left arm, and hinge forward. 1, 2, 3. You're gonna keep a slight bend in the standing leg. 4, but keeping it mostly straight. 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Switch sides. One, two, three. Whew, my balance is really off today. Four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, last one, 10. Good. All right, goblet squat, 15 reps. Grab your weight. Let's do it. One, squeeze your glutes on the way up. Two, keep your chest up. Three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Good. Drop the weight. Sumo deadlifts. My favorite exercise to do at the gym with a barbell. Feet wide apart. Toes pointed out. Pick up the weight. So again, send the hips back, keeping the back flat. And now bend your knees. Straighten and bring it forward. So it's not four discrete movements, but it's like, it flows together, but you know. Just keep in mind that you're sending your hips back first. Okay, let's go. One. Two. Three. Four. Five. Six. Seven. Eight. Nine, 10, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. All right, last exercise, Russian twists. Twenty reps. One, keep your back flat. Two, three, four, five. Really engage your obliques. Six, seven, eight, nine, 10. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. 9, 10. All right, guys, round two complete. We have one more round to do and then we will finish the workout. All right, guys, final round. We're starting with kettlebell swings, 20 reps. Remember really to hinge at your hips and push your glute, your hips and your, yeah, hips forward on the way up and squeeze your glutes. All right, one. Two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10. Nice job. Catch your breath. 12 reps squat with overhead press. Working the legs and the shoulders. All right. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10, 11, 12. Whew. That one gets the heart rate up, hey? Okay. Stability ball, chest press. I think this is the first workout I've done in like, I don't know, ever, that there's no push-ups. But, you know, we're gonna still work the chest with these chest presses, so. Okay. I'm gonna go for 7 to 8 reps. Lift the booty, squeeze the booty, brace the core. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. It's probably not the safest way to transfer the weight over. Okay. Other side. Squeeze the glutes. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. Yeah, that did it. Okay, get rid of the ball. Stability, sorry. All right, now we're doing the lunge pass through. 20 reps. Grab the weight in your right arm. Lunge back with your right leg, pass it underneath. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Okay, incline plank rows. Get into your plank. Brace the core, squeeze the glutes. One, two, don't rotate. Three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10. Shake it out. Other arm. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10. Nice job. Okay, bicep curls. I find it actually kind of annoying doing bicep curls with a kettlebell. I don't know, maybe there's a better way. I don't like it. I won't be doing that again. Anyways, let's see how I can hold it. Maybe like, nope. Grr. Okay, I'm just gonna do the best I can. One, two, three, four. I'm gonna switch to my lighter weight. Five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10. And I guess I'll go for 10 more. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10. Yeah, sorry, bicep curls with a kettlebell is a fail of an exercise, so I won't be repeating that one. Sorry about that. Okay, single leg deadlift. So I'm gonna stick with the lighter weight for this one. So put all your weight into your right leg, hinge at your hips, keep the back flat, core engaged. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10. Other side. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, whoa, nine, 10. Alrighty, the weight down, goblet squats. So grab your heavy weight. How many reps are we doing? 15. We're almost at the end of our workout, guys. Here we go. Brace the core, keep the chest up. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, 9, 10, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Good. All right, sumo deadlifts. All right. I don't know what the best angle is for me to show you. I'll try from here. Okay, feet wide, toes out. Pick up that weight, 15 reps. One, two, three, four. Really squeeze the glutes on the way up. Five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10. One, two, three, four. Now on the last one, hold it up and squeeze your glutes. Squeeze, squeeze, squeeze. Keep squeezing until I say. All right, and release. Good job. All right, guys, one last exercise. Russian twists. Here we go. 20 reps. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10. Woo! All right, you guys, we did it. Awesome job. So I hope you're feeling nice and strong from that workout. Let me know what you thought in the comments. If you like strength-focused workouts, let me know. I can do more. You know, well, I like to do a mix of everything on my channel, obviously. Like, so, but yeah, let me know what you thought. And thanks for working out with me, guys, and I'll see you in the next workout. Mwah! Bye.